Hello, boys and girls. How are we today? Seems like all I do is just haul people back and forth to the doctor's office. It's my job. Crazy, guys. Crazy. Have you guys been watching, speaking of doctors, Dr. Anthony Chafee? Young fella, surgeon. I think he's a bone surgeon. Whatever. Pretty cool guy. You gotta pull him up, check him out, check out his lifestyle. 100% carnivore. Check out his physique, and he will explain to you like no other doctor on planet Earth will the proper human diet. Now, for years, I've been listening to Dr. Ken Berry. Still do. He's a good guy. These guys are regular doctors. They were never trained when they were going to med school on proper nutrition. And they kind of stumbled into it on their own because they started to realize what they were doing in their practice was basically bullshit. Okay? Bullshit. So I'm thinking to myself, watching these guys, obviously what I'm doing isn't working. No, it's not working at all. I'm just more and more and more back, revolving door to the doctors, in and out, not getting any better. Just add more scripts, and then you freaking light bulbs going on finally, like, what in the hell? And then I've got all kind of, every time I take a script, there was a side effect, and that was worse than the damn problem I had to begin with. You know, you see how it goes, guys? And the brainwashing and the silly nonsense that they're promoting is incredible. And they're getting away with murder. Do no harm. That's bullshit. They're doing harm. Okay, so, and I'm not a medical doctor, so, you know, you can take my spiel with a grain of salt. You don't have to listen to none of my stuff. I'm just telling you what I've experienced in my life, okay, and what I've experienced in my life with modern doctors is just silly nonsense, is all it is. Money making, corruption, just like our government right now. This guy's running this circus right now. There's so much corruption that it's gaggy sick. Yeah. But it is what it is. We just have to keep voting according. And all of this nonsense, guys, all of this big pharma nonsense, corrupt government nonsense, we the people are supposed to be running the show, not this corrupt people. But we've let them take the ball and run with it. It's our own fault. We've let them take the ball and run with it. We allow them to brainwash every one of us. And that, now they're bringing in a whole new batch by the thousands. And they want to just sign them up real quick, like not my ancestors. The way they had to come through legally, you know, and all this, and come in and steal the land from the Indians, and all, you know, the whole story, right? Take away the Indians' proper nutrition that they've been living on forever, right? American bison, whatever. Yeah, that's what their main thing was, bison. Woolly mammoth. Sure, you betcha. That's why they were so badass back in the day. They were running on protein. These doctors today think you got to run on, their latest gimmick is running on Fruit Loops and Cheerios. That's in the food pyramid, by the way. Look, check it out. You talk about crazy corruption. And that's just from Big Ag throwing money at these politicians to change laws and change ideas and this and that. And all they're doing is creating a huge medical monster. Just a huge, huge laundry list of diseases caused by eating carbs, sugar, Yes, it is a moneymaker from hell. And cancer's a big one, guys. Let's face it. And this diabetes crap, that's a big one. Just totally self-inflicted nonsense. All right? It's unbelievable. I go to the gym every day, guys. I see these people. And God bless them. They're trying. And some of these men and women. It's not picking out anybody. And I go to Planet Fitness. And it's the judgment-free zone, and as it should be. You shouldn't go in there and you know, talk about this one or that one. At least they're trying, but I see these poor people in there, extremely obese, and they're just sweat just pouring off of them, and they never change. They keep the same physique. You know damn well they're pounding carbs. If they quit carbs, totally quit carbs and go strictly carnivore. Yeah, just eat meat, salt, and water. If you want to get your life back on track, just eat red meat, fatty red meat, like ribeye. If you can't do that, just get burger, some good old greasy burger. But don't throw out the grease. Eat the grease with the burger, right? You're going to heal your body. I'm telling you right now. You're going to. But I listen to some silly nonsense, the fake, okay, Fauci shot, because I have friends that didn't take that, and they said, Steve, don't take that shot. I said, no, I don't want to take the shot. I'm not going to take it. But then I had influencers corrupt my mind and had tears running down their face. Oh, you got to take a shot so you can be here with me. You're going to get that. The whole spiel was, take the shot and you won't get the virus. Well, we found out that's all BS. Yeah. I took the shot. I already took two shots and a booster. Totally stupid. Now, what Steve-O's got now is hypertension. Okay. I checked it this morning. I was 144, 80, over 80, 88. Now, that's climbing up there a bit. Yeah. But normally, I've been running about 135. 135, 78 or so. And that ain't really bad for my age. See, I'm 74, so that's not bad at all. But I'm on a medication. So if I didn't take the medication, I get up to around 150 something, 90. You know, starting to get up there. I don't think that's a good thing. So I take this medication. Hopefully my body can flush this poison. But I don't know. It may be locked in for a long time. But I have totally, guys, listen to me now, totally gone to zero carbs. Zero, zero carbs. I drink no booze of any kind. We had a party this weekend. And the libation cart, as Miss Daisy calls it, is loaded. With anything you want on it, it's loaded. Didn't touch it. No, I haven't touched any booze in 8 months. Not even a sip. Used to go to a restaurant and I'll have a glass of wine. That's over with. I don't do any of that. I'm not eating any candy, cakes, donuts, fruits. No fruit. None of it, guys. Zero carb. That's where I'm going to stay. I may stay that way for a year or two, or maybe for life. I'll keep you posted on what old Steve-O's doing, but I'm telling you right now, I have touched zero carbs. Yeah, I just thought I'd touch base with you real quick, like, and see how your life's going, and hope is all is well in your world. We have to stop. The only way we're going to change things with our corrupt government and our corrupt big pharma and big ag corruption all tied in. They're all molded into one so we can trick everyone. We have to stop buying their crappy products. Stay out of the center aisles. That's where all the junk is. This box cereal, the damn box, guys. The box itself is worth actually more money than the junk product that's within the box. It's just crap. It's all crap. It does nothing for the human body but cause cancer and diabetes and a list of other things. Gut problems, skin issues. I see they're wearing out the television with these ads, guys. For eczema, you know, psoriasis. They got the combo gimmick with arthritis and skin issue problems. You just let's ball it all into one. Why even go down that road? Why even go down that stupid road if you tune up your life and stop eating sugar? You can go to you can do just like I do. You can go to parties. You can party down with the best of them, guys. Just you go in, say, what are you drinking, Steve? I'm drinking a gin and tonic. Oh, so you see him going over and grab the tonic water. Well, if you look at tonic water, there's high fructose corn syrup in that. It's poison. Poison to the human body. All you want to do on this scenario, get your drink, you sell them a lot, and they start reaching for the Tanqueray gin, right? Say, no, whoa, wait a minute. Have you got any club soda? Yeah, there's club soda here. Oh, I said, okay, you got any lime? Okay, yes, give me a slice of lime, a little slice of lime, and some on the rocks with club soda. And you'll fake them out, guys. Just sit in there and laugh and giggle with the rest of them. Slap your knee and just have a hell of a party. Watch them get totally drunk and hammered, right? And you're fine. You're gonna be fine. You're gonna have all your senses. You'll be able to laugh and giggle with the rest of them. You know, just pretend you're drunk. You know. Yeah, that's how you do it. Just pretend you're friggin' drunk. So, guys, life goes on. We will continue on. My goal is to live to 175 years. Now, I know you're laughing right now. Okay, I know you're laughing. Like Anthony Chaffee said, there's no reason in the world why you can't live to 124, 25. Yeah. He's a young guy, solid as a freaking rock, guys. He's on it, very sharp. And these people all want you hooked up on cholesterol medication. And he has really got some good stuff on cholesterol medication. This corrupt big pharma is pushing these drugs. And just let's face it, I'm 74. They wanted me off the food chain, out of the food chain, at say 62, 65, somewhere in there. They want you, bye-bye. Eons ago, like the doctors say, you're living a lot longer than you used to, thanks to us giving you drugs. It's all bull crap, guys. Some guys probably checked out early in their 30s, whatnot, on the plains, whacking buffaloes, because they got ran over by buffaloes. Okay, they got their ass stomped by woolly mammoths. Okay, or saber-toothed tigers. A lot of those ancient people lived a long time, and I've told the doctor, no, they haven't lived that long. I've kept you alive. Oh, bullshit. You have not. You're making my life worse with all aches and pains. That's the other beauty of carnivore diet. The aches and pains start disappearing. Okay? You bet. They start disappearing. Because you start eating a high-carb diet with all the sugar in it, your body goes to a high state of inflammation. Your body starts aching. The joints start aching. These guys are having a field day, if you haven't noticed, with hip and joint knee replacements and this and that. And then the dementia. A good friend of mine's doctor, he's 80, what do you say, 85 or so? Yeah, he's got dementia. He's got a younger wife. He's on his third wife. And this younger wife, She's sad now because he's got dementia and he's checking out. He's already had a stroke. And this is the way it usually goes. You have a stroke and then another stroke. Had a buddy a year ago. He checked out from a stroke. But that was from drinking along with umpteen kajillion medications that VA. The VA is just totally corrupt. Totally corrupt. I'm so glad that I didn't get VA benefits. Because they would have thrown, and they basically want to own your ass. They're going to say, you're going to take our drug. Now, these private primary care physicians, they can suggest it. But the VA, see, back in the day when you were drafted, They owned your ass. They might as well just stamp right here, government property. Just tattoo it right on your forehead, government property, because they own your ass. Yeah, and if you get a little mouthy with you, they can throw you in handcuffs and put you in a mental institution and then pump the drugs to you and get you out of the food chain real early because you're getting to be a burden. Let's face it. At my age, to the government, they didn't expect us. You know, they put the thing at, what, 65? You can check out and get on Social Security at 62. They never our government never expected me to live to 74. I'll be 75 in May. They never expected me to live this long, but I'm going to trick the shit out of them. Of course, the way Numbnut Joe's blowing the money, that money's going to be gone. I might have to survive on my friggin' hunting instincts, my hunting knowledge to survive. And I could probably do fairly well. It's going to be a tough way to go, I'm telling you right now. Being a hunter is a tough way to go. Hadez or whatever, look those guys up. The hunter-gatherers are the last ones in Africa right now. There's like 300 to 400 of them left, and they're hunter-gatherers. They do eat some plant-based stuff, but they're basically meat eaters, and they'll eat bats to rats to I saw them the other day dragging in aardvark, a great big pig looking thing with a friggin pig nose on this thing. He looks like a overgrown hamster or something. They eat those warthogs and are even, they make poison arrows. They cook down some plant and paint their arrows with it. They're pounding out, they're getting some modern steel from somebody. I notice a lot of them are wearing shorts, modern shorts. Apparently these documentary guys that come in and start filming them and bringing them shorts and shirts and whatnot. But they eat a lot of baboon, and they will even eat a hyena, believe it or not. And these guys are funny. They got their own language, and it's a clicking sound. The Bushmen, Kalahari Bushmen, the little skinny guys that can run forever, they have a clicking sound too that they do. And they store water and out in the desert area inside of ostrich eggs, put a wood plug in it, a little bit of grass, now screw a wood plug in that thing and hide those ostrich eggs out on the desert. And they know where they're at, get the food and all, but I mean the water. But these guys here, Tanzania, I think is where they're at. Check them out online. They are right. I've been watching them every day, and they're the happiest people, these hunters. And they have a really rough lifestyle, but they do quite well with their homemade bow and arrows. Their arrows look to be 3 to 4 foot, about 3 feet long, and they do put poison on some. They've got different arrows for different species. Like if they see a small dove, they can shoot doves, small doves up in a tree. And same way with they don't waste their arrows too much when they trap an animal up in a tree, like shooting them with a broadhead. I think they're saving them broadheads, poison broadheads, for big game like large kudu and Cape buffalo. These guys are killing Cape buffalo guys with these arrows. And their bows, I don't know, almost look like a hickory bow. They're like round stock. And the strings, I would love to see them document how they make the arrows and how they make the bows and what type of wood, the whole, you know, break the whole process down. Yeah, it would be fun, really fun to see that. I enjoy those documentaries like that, but these are the last tribe in Africa that are really hunter-gatherers, and they're starting to get pushed down, you know, because agriculture's in there. And they're getting pushed down. But these guys live off it. They don't go around killing cattle, somebody's cattle, no. There are the Maasai out there that they're cattlemen, and they eat a lot of, they drink a lot of blood, milk and blood. And they do eat meat, cattle meat, but yeah, that's a different group. These guys are strictly hunters, gatherers. it's really fun to watch them, and they're just happy people. They sit around, they got their cannabis, I guess in the afternoon they're smoking that. I guess they start their day smoking a little cannabis, and then they finish the day smoking cannabis. But they, a lot of times they out on a hunt, they just gather up, and they'll build a little fire, and then they just sleep right there on the ground, right out there under the trees, just like, you know, like a wild animal. And so anyway, that's fun to watch. But watch Anthony Chaffee, and you guys are going to start learning some very cool stuff. And my doctor totally disagrees with it. You have to have fiber and this and that. You don't need fiber. That is all bullshit. Every bit, I tell him, it's bullshit. That's all it is. It's misinformation. It's fake news. I tell him, you're pushing fake news. And he just, blood starts boiling. And then he starts smiling, thinking, you stupid fool, you don't know what you're talking about. I know what I'm talking about because I've done it. I'm there. I've been doing it. I've been doing this now. I'm going on like 5 or 6 years now. I forget exactly when. But now I'm totally, 100% carb free. Zero. No sugar in this body whatsoever. It's poison. So I suggest, if you want to clean up your act and go down the Steve-O route, try it. You're not going to really get benefits to you. You've been there for like 90 days. So, you know, that's a good while. 90 days is a good while. But you will have trouble. I've talked to a lot of friends and stuff that have tried, I can't do what you do. Well, what's happened is the carb addiction, it's a drug. Sugar is a drug. Big Pharma knows this. They know they can keep you in a high state of inflammation. Just watch your television, guys. Tony the Tiger Frosted Flake stuff is all just, it warping your mind. All these drugs, one after the other. And they show fat people and stuff just out dancing. They got a little fat lady. She dances. She's pulling her skirt around. And she's just as happy as a good-looking woman, all right? But her body's just totally blown out, obese. But they present it as okay. You know, you're going to be okay. You're a big fat ass. You're going to be okay if you take our drug. So get that in your friggin' skull. Lock it in to your hair covered computer. Do not delete it. We have warped your friggin' mind. All right. So I just thought I'd touch base. I got to keep throwing these at you guys. And I'm your guinea pig, okay? Let's just say, okay, Steve-O, we're going to watch you. We're going to watch you and see how you do. That's exactly what I want you guys to do. So the more people I can get on the carnivore train, the better. We're going to start changing things. You can't change things unless you try it. And then once you find out it's working, you got all your sick friends around, you just tell them, they say, what are you doing? I mean, you're looking good. You're doing really well. What are you doing? Well, one thing I don't do is listen to these phony assholes anymore, giving me all these drugs and crap that don't work. Okay. You take a drug for this and it creates 4 or 5 other problems. They're laughing all the way to the bank. And you're the one getting screwed by these people, okay? So you can go down the road if you want, but if you want change, yeah, you want change, do what I'm saying. Let's get away from these people and then call them out. As you get better and things start changing for you, call them out. I've been calling them out on the Fauci shot because I've told them before, listen, I was fine. I was on 0 meds until I got the phony Fauci shot. Now look at me today. I'm on hypertension medication again. But I'm hopefully and asking God to help me get off of this crap, okay? Clean up my body, and I think it'll happen. I think it'll happen. Because the man has come to my rescue in the past. So I think he's going to come to me again. If Steve-O's a good boy and he doesn't spank himself, all right, we'll get through this. And staying on zero carb is the way I'm going, okay? So that's all for today. God bless you. Be happy, be strong. We got to keep getting it on and stop listening to these crazy, corrupt fools. See you later. Bye-bye.